I hope you got here comfortably. Yeah, I heard it wasn't voluntary, but it usually isn't. I apologize if I interrupted any of your plans. I'm not expecting this to take long. I'm just gonna have a quick dinner with you, discuss some things, and then you can go. I guess the first things I have to bring up is your reputation. We've been hearing a lot about you, Gabriel. Your name's been coming up all over town. It's the only thing some of my guys are talking about. Apparently you have a noticeable grit, and that's a good thing. Grit's becoming harder and harder to find around here. It's important to have grit. I wish your generation understood that. You know, it'd make things a lot easier to keep running. I got these friends, they say their kids are ready for the business, but they ain't. They're missing that oomph, the flair, the look, you know what I mean? Between you and me, this whole new generation lacks oomph. Nobody's willing to get their hands dirty, like I did. And just when you're not willing to cross that line, there's no drive to go any further. I mean, this generation, they're not interested in power. The feeling it gives, the pleasure of it, that satisfaction of knowing that anybody will do whatever you tell them or else. I don't know what they're thinking, trying to figure out their gender and some crap like that. You know, two waters, please. But you, you're different. I've heard the stories. You seem to show a lot of oomph. Yeah, I heard about that bar incident. Brutal what you did to those guys. To my guys, huh? But I know you meant nothing by it. They'll survive. Most of them anyway. Ball's still up in the air on my nephew though, whether he's gonna make it or not. Andrew. Yeah. I don't think you two exchanged names before you decided to crush his neck with your shoe. He's in the hospital right now breathing from a tube. The only kid that I thought had potential, and you, go ahead and put them down. No, we're ready to order. Just get two of my usuals. Yeah, man, I'm sorry about that, you know. I got to rambling a bit. It's just that we've been looking for a guy like you. You know, my son, his kids aren't gonna grow up to be tough. I think I went too easy on them. They never got to experience what it was like to come from nothing and pull yourself higher. But I bet you have, though. You look like you could get yourself into some trouble. Like that bruise on your forehead. Bruises are nothing to be ashamed of. The most important people in my life, all of them covered in bruises. This one guy I knew back in junior high, and he had so many bruises, you'd think he'd like getting beat up. But his manner told you different. Now, this kid was real sort of tough, really shifty eyes. I guarantee you, no matter how bad he was beat up, everybody thought he had won whatever fight he was in. Well, this guy, his name is Chris. You know, we started hanging out under the bleachers, smoking cigarettes in class. You know, one day we're sitting there smoking and I asked him, you know, hey, where'd you get this black eye from? Because this newest injury, oh, it was a big old mark on the right side of his eye. Well, to my surprise, you know, it wasn't from a fight or nothing. It was actually from a, oh, grazie, you can put the plate down here. Ah, oh, you're gonna love this pork. Best cut of meat around here. Yeah, you know, and back to the story, all the bruises were from his dad. Now, he was an alcoholic, a bad one. Now, Chris told me every time he'd come back from the bar, which I assume was every night, Chris would get a terrible beating. No, made me realize, Chris wasn't tough because he beat other kids up. Chris was tough because he went through hell every night. You know, kid got the crap beat out of him for nothing, never let it get to him. Yeah, but you know, Chris, he probably should have cared. You know, done something about his dad. Because when he got laid off his job, boy, was he pissed. You know, he finally gave Chris a bruise he couldn't walk away from. At that moment, I finally saw Chris at a point of weakness. That goddamn monster finally found a way to break him, to give him a scar that he couldn't take. But that was the first time I ever learned that lesson about power about strength. It's not about being able to take the hits, it's about being able to stop them. When I realized that, I snapped too in a way. If Chris didn't have the power to end things, then I had to, and I did. His father was the first time I ever exerted power over someone. And I'm glad I did it. It was messy. I wasn't thinking about getting away with it, but I didn't care. I just knew that I could never, ever let someone hurt somebody close to me and live without any consequences. And I live by that now. So when I heard you hurt my nephew, I planned on killing you. I talked to guys about plans, about what to do with you. And you know what? They liked you. They thought you were worth keeping around. But I don't see it. I don't see any of that grit these guys are talking about. All I see is a goddamn coward who's too afraid to look me in the eyes. Is that what you are? A coward? Huh? Did you look my nephew in the eyes? Want me to stomp on his freaking neck? Did you? Answer me, goddammit!
I looked him in the eyes and he never looked back!
Oh, well, look who's finally his oomph. You know, I get you this whole dinner, and I gotta stick a gun to your head to get a conversation out of you? Goddamn teenagers. Frickin' manners. Get this guy out of the robots. We'll be seeing you around, dude.